Hello, welcome to NetVN channel. If you have a Netgear Wi-Fi router, you can make yourself a VPN server with it. Here I have a Netgear router and I will set it up as a VPN server. You need to make sure your router is connected to the internet. From a Windows 11 computer, I access the Netgear router management page with any web browser. The default IP address of the Netgear router is 192.168.1.1. The password is generated when you set up the router for the first time. You go to the advanced settings of the Netgear router and enable the VPN service. Netgear router uses OpenVPN to create VPN server. You just need to activate the VPN service, then see the instructions below. It supports different operating systems like Windows, Linux, Android and iOS. Here I download the configuration files for the Windows client. To connect to the VPN server, you need a static public IP address or use a dynamic domain name service. By default, Netgear uses services like NoIP, but it is a paid extra service. I'd rather use the free service, so I'll use another dynamic domain name. The dynamic domain name service I use is DynuDNS. It helps you create domain names for free. Here I have created a domain name to use as a VPN server. That domain name is netvn.freeddns.org. To update the public IP address dynamically, you install the above tool for Windows operating system. This tool helps you to update your public IP address every time it changes. DynuDNS service will help you map your domain name with public IP address so you don't have to worry when it changes. So the public IP address has been updated and mapped with my domain name. Next, you edit the OpenVPN configuration file for the client computer. I will replace the public IP address with my domain name. So when the public IP address changes, the client computer can still connect to the OpenVPN server on the Netgear router. Now on a laptop, I set it up as an OpenVPN client. While waiting for the configuration, you can check out the t-shirt samples at the bottom of the video. There you will find t-shirts that suit you. Going back to the client VPN computer, you need to make sure the client has the necessary configuration files. Then I went to the OpenVPN homepage and downloaded the VPN client as follows. Next, I downloaded the older version to match the Netgear router. I download the OpenVPN client 2.5. Latest client VPN version may cause unexpected error when connecting to Netgear router. If you have the latest Netgear router, you should probably download the latest version of OpenVPN for Windows computers. After downloading, install it like any other software. Here you are prompted to add configuration files to a folder called config. I copied the config files to the folder named config as instructed. Each Windows computer client has four configuration files as above. You need to make sure your domain config file is up to date. When you install OpenVPN on a Windows computer, it creates a new network interface, including an interface called Tap Windows Adapter. You will see it like above and you will rename it Netgear VPN. The setup steps are done. Now you just need to establish a connection to the OpenVPN server and check the results. So I have finished introducing how to set up a VPN server with a Netgear router. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Don't forget to choose a t-shirt for yourself below the video. The connection is established. I will go to the Netgear router and see the results. That way I can access the Netgear router management page from outside the internet. Also, I can access to my intranet shared folder.